The menu system on Osmo Action 4 is really similar to Osmo Action 3. But if you are not familiar with Osmo Action 3 menu, I'm gonna give you an intro now for Osmo Action 4. On the top left, 2 hours 21 minutes, that's how much recording time you have left. When you click on the play button, no files on SD card, confirm. Down here, it said video, click on that, you can choose photo and different setups that I have saved. But you have also slow-mo and time-lapse. Under time-lapse, we have time-lapse and hyperlapse. With time-lapse, you can swipe up to set duration and interval. With hyperlapse, we have the interval down here, from automatic all the way to 30. Up here, resolution, 4K, and slow-mo. We have resolution. With the 4K, you can only shoot in 120. With 1080, you have all the way up to 240. On the right bottom here, you have 1x, that's the zoom. Tap and hold to adjust digital zoom. On the top right, you have a battery status. Press on it, I will show 72% of my battery now. And here you have the settings, exposure, colors, white balance, and the field of view. And down here, this is new on Osmo Action 4. Click on that. And custom, you can set the sharpness from 2 all the way down to minus 2. I leave it at 0. And noise reduction, minus 2 all the way up to 1. I leave it at minus 2. Minus 2, no noise reduction will give the sharpest image. And sharpness at 0. Could be too sharp. 1 is actually really sharp. And 2 is over sharpened. And minus 2 if you want to do it yourself in post-production. But I leave it at 0. And you have also presets. For now you have only portrait. And just click confirm. And the color you have normal. And D-Log M with 10-bit. And the sharpness and noise reduction is the same here. It will get automatic saved. Field of view. Ultra-wide is the widest. Wide and D-Warp. D-Warp is to get the straight lines. I use ultra-wide. And exposure. You have manual or automatic. I have it at automatic and leave auto up to 800 or 1600. With Osmo Action 4, you could actually go up to 1600 without no problems. With the old one, you could actually go only up to 800 until you get a lot of noise in the image. And up here you can see, now it's using 790 ISO. I click it up to 3002, still 790. So that's an indicator when you're out shooting that I'm indoors now and I can see I don't need more than 800. And still it will be enough. But 1600 or 800 is what I can recommend. On the left side, you can choose if you want it to be darker or brighter. All the way up to plus 3. And now you can see it uses 1600 ISO. Go all the way. Now it's shooting really dark, minus 3. And now it only uses 270 ISO. With blue sky, I can recommend to use... just now I have it at 0. But just a little bit darker. with 0.3, it will give you a really nice color in the sky. And you will not blow out the highlights that easy if you have it at there instead of at zero. But you can also click manual. And here you can set the shutter speed. If you are shooting in 60 frames per second, I recommend, or the norm is to use 120 or higher. But if you are like me, driving in different light conditions, I use it at automatic, so let the camera decide itself and just use auto ISO. So I'm gonna click on automatic, confirm. White balance. I have it at manual at 5500 Kelvin. Automatic will give me 5650 for the same when I'm indoors. Automatic will change all the time when you're out vlogging or driving. So leave it at manual. Now it have changed to 5700 and I'm gonna put it down to 5500. And I'm in pro mode. Click off pro mode and you have enabling the image stabilization in low light. Enable or cancel. I took cancel. You don't need it if you are pro. And here also the sharpness. But pro mode is what we like to use. If you're a vlogger, you can use the Boya BYK4 mic adapter. It's a USB-C to TRS. Just open on the left and plug it in. And now I have plugged the microphone adapter with a microphone. And now you can see the sound level up here. It's not peaking, it's only one. Click here and you see it's really hard to see, but there you have the microphone. And now it's at minus 10. With Osmo Action 4 you can go all the way down to minus 20 or all the way up plus 30. I have found minus 10 works great when you are using inside a helmet. Minus 5 also could work, but 0 or even higher will probably give you distorted sound. They have changed how it works internally in Osmo Action 4 compared to Osmo Action 3. So that's why not only that you have minus 20, but also the mic gain inside. The analog mic gain is different than it used to be on Osmo Action 3. About the menu, just drag from the top. And if you have top left, you can save your settings. I have different settings here. And if you go to quick switch, you can set up what your quick switch button on the left will do when you press on it. Voice prompt, I use it off. I use the quick switch, go straight to my preferred settings, 4K at 60, 4x3. I have a disable photo, I have only video and hyperlapse. On the sun, you have the brightness on the screen. I have it at 20 now. You're gonna change it depending how bright or dark it is where you are. Up to the right, I have it on snapshot, last settings, single screen preview, I have it off, voice control, I have it off, OTD connection, it's a type C USB to PD cable to connect your camera to Android device like a phone, wireless connection, wireless info, frequency 5.8 or 2.4, video compression. With H265 you can use 10-bit. If you have a fast computer or your editing software for videos supports H265, use it. Sounds, I have it on mute. I don't like to have a lot of sounds when I'm clicking. Grid, I have it on grid. We can have different kind. If you have a timecode unit, you can use it to sync all your cameras. Naming management. I would like to see that I have different system on it, on this one. But I have called it UL4 and UL4 on both file name. It's Osmo Action 4. So all my files will have UL4. Screen off when recording, 3 seconds is the shortest. Osmo Action 3 doesn't have 15 seconds or 3 seconds or I don't know. Auto power off. It is when the camera will turn off completely. For this demonstration I have it at 10 minutes. Usually, it all depends. 1 minute, 2 minutes. Depends what I'm doing. And screen off recording, I'm gonna actually put it up to 30 seconds just for this demonstration. LED, I have it off, but you can turn it on. Horizon calibration, if it's not calibrated, you can do it there. Here you can continue last live stream. And here you have Bluetooth remote controller, and you can choose to wake up the camera. This one probably only works when the camera is in standby mode, so you can't wake up the camera the day after. The language, English, date and time, it should be synced up with your phone. The format is to format your card. Factory reset to set up the default. Here we have device info. I must the newest firmware, 0.730. And camera firmware. Here you can also find a quick start guide and also export the log for the camera. If you have any problems and need to contact DJI, they will ask for export log. Compliance info, well, a lot of info about your camera. This one, it's orientation, lock off, I have it on, so it will always stay the right direction. And here you can lock your screen, swipe up for unlock, enable for voice commands, and here we have full front screen off, on and off. With Osmo Action 4, you can actually take off the original glass you have and use this one. That will have not the glass and will give you better performance in low light. I have it on now just for the purpose of this video, but I never tried it before. Another new thing with Osmo Action 4 is this one. You probably wonder what is this one for. It's actually for using with your screw when you have it mounted here. If it will shake, you can put them between these ones. Will give you really good grip. A quick tip. This magnet mount, the DJI logo should always face forward where you are recording. It's actually logic. It's like advertising. You don't need to see it yourself. One thing I want to point out. The newest firmware, the color should have 10-bit recording. So we need to test it out. Osmo Action 4 and Osmo Action 3 have Rocksteady 3.0. With ordinary Rocksteady, it should be good enough for most of your driving. Rocksteady Plus gives a little bit more crop in, but will give you really good boost in the stabilization. Should be used when you are jogging or something, or just need it. Horizon balancing. You can tilt the camera 45 angle each direction. And what's new with Osmo Action 4, in 2.7K you have not only horizon balancing but horizon steady as well. And with horizon steady you can actually have a lot of cool videos you can make when the camera is tilting. So give it a try. Also, if you're shooting, let me say 4K 4x3, go to Rocksteady off, then you will have gyro data recording at the file that you can use Gyroflow or other software to actually give the best stabilization you can actually get in any action camera. So even in the darkness you can get stabilized footage where Rocksteady or other image stabilization will not work. That's really great. And now I have put the lens on again, and you need to tighten it really much for it to be watertight. This is the magnet mount from Osmo Action 3. With 4 you get this one. It looks more steady. The rubber on this one is I don't know. It feels more steady compared to the old one from Osmo Action 3.